All right, so it's time to actually talk about a topic. And my first topic will be on US news. Now, I know in American news right now, the big event was the bombing during the Boston Marathon. It's a pretty big event, in America at least, although these kinds of bombings, significantly worse, happen every day in other parts of the world. The fact that it happens in America is I guess, a big deal to us because we, you know, it just... Anyway, that's happened. It's a big news story. And I honestly don't want to talk about it because it's one of those things where, I don't know. Personally, I don't think there's too much for me to talk about at this point. It's going to be one of those things where I saw a footage... Because I've been kind of staying away from this news in particular, because it's not something that it interests me. And that's not to say, it is a really, really tragic and important story, of course. But it has one of those potential to be a really politically, it could be a political tool for politicians to spin the story as it goes on. And I don't like that aspect. It's a tragedy. It's a bombing. It happened in America, so it really got us riled up. But it also, these kinds of things happen all the time around the world, and worse ways, you know. So it's unfortunate, but I don't really want to talk about it. That's why I am not going to talk about it. I think This is a topic that I'll revisit in the future when things do get political, because then I'll be like, holy crap, like this is too much right now. We are overreacting, or you know, what is possible happening is, like, you know, we currently don't know who did the attack. I don't think we do, at least. I don't know. Maybe at the time of this uploading, you know, it will all already have gone political. And I do have a negative connotation to the word term political there. But yeah, I was watching the Young Turks, Cenk Uygur, talk about this. And, like, really, I'll link his video in the description of this video, because I think it's a really important video to watch about this. But yeah, I really feel like this is a situation where we can end up overreacting and definitely also underreacting too. So, not a topic I want to talk about. Maybe later I'll revisit if some things get totally blown overboard and I'm just like, look, right, here's my thoughts now, because this has become way out of line. That's not what I want to talk about. I want to talk about, to me, what feels like a really another political thing, but something I do have interesting thoughts on. Well, not interesting, but just pretty, it's a pretty thought-provoking thing. So, it involves the Supreme Court. Right now, I mean, Supreme Court recently has been posed some very interesting questions. You know, it's always, they have the role of answering some pretty unique questions so far. Most recently, they had to answer, you know, they had to debate with this question, like, is it unconstitutional to ban gay marriage, to not allow marriage to gay people, you know, across the country. So that's what they're debating right now on DOMA, and they're also debating Proposition 8. They're not debating, but they're deciding on it currently. And they're also deciding, there was something else that they're deciding on. But, you know, when it comes to, like, is it unconstitutional, that's lawyer talk. You know, what we mean is, what we common folk ask is it okay? You know, that's where the debate happens. Right now, I guess it's recently come to my attention, and it's interesting where my news sources come from now, where how I get my news in this day and age. To me, it's like, whoa, and interesting to me, because it can happen not just on the mainstream news sites like CNN or Washington Post or New York Times, but also it can happen simply because I stumbled onto my Twitter feed and clicked on a link. It can happen because I went to my Facebook page and one of my friends posted a link, you know, that way. It can also happen because I checked out my YouTube subscription box and I was just like, whoa, there's this video that I'm going to click. And I watched it, that's interesting. And I backed into my subscription box. There was another YouTube channel that does a similar story. I think one of my favorite video that I watched so far is by RT Russian Times. So it is a news site, but it's an interesting story. It's the fact that right now Supreme Court is deciding on the question, is it, I don't know if they're deciding on the constitutionality. I mean, that's obviously what they do in the Supreme Court, but I like to reframe the question as a common folk. Is it okay? Is it okay to patent a human gene? Because apparently there's a BRCA1, I forgot the name of the gene, but it's a gene that once you detect it, it really helps to, it impacts prevention of like breast cancer and such. So it's a really important gene. One company has developed, spent a lot of money, you know, billions and billions of dollars, coming up, finding this gene and finding its important role in the gene, and so it's patented it. I didn't realize that human genes have been patented by biotech corporations and genetic engineering companies and stuff of that nature. This is, to me, mind-blowing that this is going on and has gone on. It's finally come to the question of deciding whether this is okay. And I would hope, my personal gut feeling is like, no, this is not okay. This is the human gene. A company should not be totally own what is done with this gene, have the ownership of whatever is the information of these genes, the manipulation of these genes. It's a human gene, for God's sake. So I would hope, you know, your viewers' response, gut reaction is in the same way as an ethical question. Is it morally right to have human gene patented? That's the question here. But it goes deeper than that. But I mean, what's surprising is, yeah, this has been going on, and the reporters of both stories, the both videos I watched, because I only watched two videos, I haven't delved too much into this, so this is pretty much my gut reaction at this point. Just I haven't done a lot of research on this topic. I'm just kind of talking, you know, reaction here. Just this is a reaction video, I guess. So there were two reporters like, keep in mind that, you know, human genes have been patented before, and that this has happened a lot. And it just keeps talking about this current issue. I'm just like, wait, what? It has been, and it currently is. Well, like, is this one of the most underreported stories, or is it that I just haven't been paying attention? What's been going on in this realm? Like, how are we not aware? Like, I feel like, you know, there is this one time, I think it was a TED Talk video or TED Talk speech where it talks about like how news is reported, and it had a pie chart. It's like this percentage, like, you know, this amount of the pie is the reporting done on Iraq. This amount of the pie is done on, like, you know, and it's just like, and this amount is done on poverty. It's just like this small pie chart. So it's like definitely underreporting is a big thing. And I feel like this aspect of the news has been hugely underreported. It makes sense why it would be if the players involved are multi-billion corporations who are in charge of coming up with pharmaceutical solutions like pills and surgery methods that would rake in amazing amount of profit because it's there to fight cancer and such of that nature. So yeah, morally, it's like one company holding all the information about a gene, and that information can help prevent cancer for a lot of people. Holy crap. Like, morally, it's completely wrong. But at the same time, I feel like going deeper into it, I mean, playing devil's advocate with myself, funding in science is a big, big issue. How do we fund scientific endeavors? If these things can't be patented, then would something like this gene have been discovered in the first place? Because that's an incentive for a lot of these companies. They spent billions of dollars into discovering this gene. So why would they spend so much if they can't actually make a profit of that investment? You know, so that's the, now we've gone from the moral aspect of things into the actual, I guess, societal or just the reality of things. You know, ideally, in an ideal ethical society, this information would be, everyone would be trying to discover this new gene. They would be funded by society, I guess, somehow, by government or whatever, by fundraising, by donations. Everyone will be funded well, and once they discover the genes, the information will be shared all equally, and cancer will be cured. Ideally. That doesn't happen in the real world, unfortunately. Especially in America, where there are health care is an industry. Health research is an industry. You know, genetic research is an industry. These are businesses. They're not, well, there is like National Institute of Health, but even then, there are branches of NIH and things like that. It is an industry. And when you have an industry working to cure mankind's ills, there is an issue of incentive. And this is where I kind of don't know how to answer these things, other than just to present it as a question, you know? Obviously, my gut reaction is that Supreme Court should rule against the patent. Like, this company should not be able to patent a human gene. It has been gone on. So if this case, if Supreme Court does decide that and says it's unconstitutional because genes happen in nature and you can't patent something that you haven't invented, but just merely discovered. It's a slippery slope argument right there. But anyway, if that decision is made, then all the human patents that have happened in the past, all the patents on human genes, all the current existing patents, will be null and void. That would be the picture, I guess. And that would dramatically change the landscape of these industries. And the question is, how negatively impactful would that be? Would we no longer be able to find a cure for something like cancer because of that? Well, that's a pretty loaded question. I don't really, like I said, I'm not an expert. This is a really big thought experiment for me. The one reason I'm doing this topic is because it's so mind-boggling to me that this is happening right now. And then I'm not able to come up with a clear-cut answer other than saying, ethically, this is wrong. But then I do have to also consider the real-world aspect of things. You know, maybe it's not a big deal. Maybe human genes can't be patented, which would be, you know, would go with my values and ideals. And I think it's ethically right, it's morally right that human genes aren't allowed to be patented. But then again, I'm a very ethically driven person. If I had it my way, surrogacy would be unethical, you know, which I consider as selling of artificial babies. You know, it's a baby industry. That's what I consider. It's really unethical to me, but that's a whole different topic. So considering this type of person that I am, maybe I'm having an overreaction and thinking that this is, whoa, this is like unethical territory here. Maybe it's not. That's just my thinking this way. It's a pretty tough topic for me, in just thinking about the landscape of things, the landscape of the industry. It's weird because, I mean, that one company, I really can't see how it can win in the court. Like, I feel like the lawyer who is defending this company, who has all the rights and all the patents to these two human genes, that lawyer has his work cut off for him, or her. Could be a female lawyer. Or a transgender lawyer, I don't know. But yeah, crazy issue. So that's my topic for today. I don't really have anything definitive to say on this topic. My thoughts are pretty much just that it really ethically irks me. But on the business side of things, I don't know. It could be detrimental to the industry if Supreme Court does rule against patenting of a human gene. Should that matter? That's another question. Should it matter if it does negatively impact the industry of the biotech companies and the genetical research companies? Does it matter? Should it matter? Like, does the ethics trump everything. Ideally, I feel like it should, but then what are the real-life consequences of a Supreme Court ruling against patenting of a human gene? Just some questions out there. So that's me on this topic.